Dear students, hope you all are fine. Let's begin with chapter 7, Bioenergetics. Bioenergetics is the study of energy relationships and energy transformations in living organisms. As you know, energy exists in two forms, potential energy and kinetic energy. Organisms obtain energy by metabolizing the food they eat or prepare. Food contains potential energy in its bonds. When these bonds are broken down, a large amount of kinetic energy is released. Some of the energy is stored in the form of potential energy in the bonds of ATP molecules, while the rest escapes as heat. This potential energy of ATP is again transformed into kinetic energy to carry out the life activities. Now, the role of ATP. The major energy currency of all cells is a nucleotide called adenosine triphosphate. It is the main energy source for the majority of the cellular functions, like synthesis of macromolecules, example DNA, RNA and proteins, movements, transmission of nerve impulses, active transport, exocytosis, endocytosis. Now next topic is oxidation reduction reactions. Various life processes in organisms involve constant flow of energy. For all life processes, oxidation reduction reactions are the direct source of energy. Redox reactions involve exchange of electrons between atoms. The loss of electrons is called oxidation, and the gain of electrons is called reduction. Look at this figure 7.2. When compound A loses electrons, it is oxidized. And compound B gets these electrons and it is reduced. In living organism, redox reactions involve the loss and gain of hydrogen atoms. We know that a hydrogen atom contains one proton and one electron. It means that when a molecule loses a hydrogen atom, it actually loses an electron and oxidation takes place. And similarly, when a molecule gains hydrogen atom, it actually gains an electron, mean reduction take place. Now structure of ATP, page number 119. The ability of ATP to store and release energy is due to its molecular structure. Figure 7.3 shows simplified diagrams of ATP. Each ATP molecule has three subunits. First, adenine. It is a double ring nitrogenous base. Second, a ribose, which is a 5-carbon sugar. And third is 3-phosphate groups in a linear chain. ATP, adenosine triphosphate. When it contains only two molecules of phosphate, it is called adenosine diphosphate, mean ADP. When it contains only one molecule of phosphate, it is called adenosine monophosphate. Now, how energy is released from ATP? Look at these equations. When ATP loses one phosphate molecule, 7.3 kilocalorie energy is released. Similarly, when ADP loses another phosphate molecule, again 7.3 kilocalorie energy is released. Similarly, when formation of ATP takes place from AMP to ADP, 7.3 kilocalorie energy is required. And when ADP is converted into ATP, again 7.3 kilocalorie energy is required. Next topic is photosynthesis, page number 120. Photosynthesis is the synthesis of glucose from carbon dioxide and water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll, oxygen as byproduct. Byproduct means it is not required for plants. Photosynthesis is an anabolic process and is an important component of bioenergetics in living organism. Nearly all life depends on it. It comprises many coordinated biochemical reactions that occur in plants, algae and some bacteria. Water and CO2 are the raw material of photosynthesis. Plants have mechanism for the intake and transport of these raw materials. Now, how water intake occurs? Water is absorbed from soil by roots and root hairs through osmosis and salts by active transport. Water reaches through the leaves, through the xylem vessels. You will study about them in chapter 9 in detail. Next, how intake of CO2 takes place. The air that enters leaf through the tiny pores called stomata reaches into the air spaces present around mesophyll cells, which are the specialized cells for photosynthesis. This air carries CO2, which gets absorbed in the thin layer of water surrounding mesophyll cells. From here, the carbon dioxide diffuses into mesophyll cell. Before proceeding to mechanism of photosynthesis, students, you must know about two main high energy molecules of this procedure. One is ATP and second is NAD. It stands for nicotine amide adenine dinucleotide. Is a coenzyme that takes electron and hydrogen ion and is reduced to NADH. One form of this coenzyme also carries phosphate called NADP, and it also takes electrons and hydrogen to reduce its NADPH. Now, mechanism of photosynthesis, page 121. It occurs in two phases, light reaction, dark reaction. During first phase, light energy is captured and is used to make high energy molecules ATP and NADPH. These reactions are known as light reactions. They take place on the thylakoid membranes of chloroplast. During second phase, carbon dioxide is reduced to make glucose. In this phase, the energy from high energy molecules ATP and NADPH is utilized. Since these reactions do not use direct sunlight, so they are known as dark reactions. It takes place in stroma of the chloroplast. Now this figure 7.4 shows the summary of photosynthesis. Look at this. Light is trapped by thylakoid. Water molecule is utilized in this reaction. Oxygen is produced. And conversion of NADP and ADP into NADPH and ATP can also be seen here. A circle shows the dark reactions. CO2 is utilized and glucose is formed during dark reactions. Next steps or events of light reactions. When chlorophyll molecules absorb light, their energy level increases and their electrons are emitted. The electrons are passed to electron transport chain to produce ATP from ADP. Sunlight also breaks water molecule. This is called photolysis. Photo means light and lysis means breakdown. Due to photolysis, oxygen is released and it leaves the chloroplast. The hydrogen atoms of water give electrons to chlorophyll and becomes ions. The electrons of chlorophyll after the production of ATP and the hydrogen ions of water are used for the reduction of NADP to NADPH. This whole series of light reactions is called Z scheme due to its Z shape. Look at figure 7.5. When light falls, photolysis of water occurs and two electrons are transferred to the chlorophyll and pass through electron transport chain and provide energy for synthesis of ATP. The two electrons are transferred to another chlorophyll molecules. Now these electrons and hydrogen ion are required for reduction of NADP to NADPH. Here light reactions stop and next phase of photosynthesis, dark reactions start. Page number 122. The details of dark reactions discovered by Melvin Kelvin. That's why these reactions are also called Kelvin cycle. Look at Kelvin cycle, figure 7.6. ATP and NADPH, which were produced during light reactions, are now utilized in second phase. Here, first of all, carbon dioxide gas molecules combined with 5 carbon compounds which already present in stroma and form temporary 6 carbon compounds, each of which split into 2-3 carbon compounds. In next step, each 3 carbon compounds are reduced to 3 carbon carbohydrates by using ATP and hydrogen from NADPH. Here students, what is the difference between carbon compound and carbon carbohydrates? Carbon compound means simple compound in which carbon is present, but carbon carbohydrates means that carbon is present but in a special combination with hydrogen and oxygen with ratio of 1:2:1. CH2O. This is the empirical formula of carbohydrates, which means simple sugar. In the next step, one of the three carbon carbohydrates are used to manufacture glucose. The other three carbon carbohydrates are also used to regenerate the original five carbon compound. This step also utilizes ATP. So students, in this way, when ATP and NADPH are utilized and oxidized into ADP and NADP, they again enter into light reactions. These digits 5, 3, 3, 3, 6, 6 shows the number of molecules participating during dark reactions. In this way, the products of light reaction, ATP and NADPH, other than oxygen, are utilized in dark reactions, and after completion of dark reactions, original 5 carbon compound and high energy molecules are regenerated. Now, our next topic is role of light, page number 122 and 123. As you know, sunlight is necessary for light reactions. So, light is absorbed by leaf surfaces by chlorophyll. The light rays of different wavelengths are not only differentially absorbed by photosynthetic pigments but also differentially effective in photosynthesis. The blue and red lights carry out more photosynthesis. Now, role of chlorophyll. Photosynthetic pigments are organized in the form of clusters called photosystem in thylakoid membranes of chloroplast. Chlorophyll A is the main photosynthetic pigments which effectively absorbs red and blue lights. Other pigments are called accessory pigments, which are chlorophyll B, carotenoid and xanthophyll. Now next topic is limiting factors in photosynthesis, page number 124. Any environmental factor, the absence or deficiency of which can decrease the rate of a metabolic reaction, is called limiting factor for that reaction. Many factors like light intensity, temperature, concentration of carbon dioxide and availability of water act as limiting factors for photosynthesis. Effect of light intensity and photosynthesis. The rate of photosynthesis varies with light intensity. It decreases as light intensity decreases and increases as intensity increases. However, at much higher light intensity, the rate of photosynthesis becomes constant. Now, effect of temperature on photosynthesis. The rate of photosynthesis decreases with decrease in temperature. It increases as temperature is increased over a limited range. But if light intensity is low, increasing the temperature has little influence on the rate of photosynthesis. Next, effect of carbon dioxide concentration on photosynthesis. As carbon dioxide concentration rises, the rate of photosynthesis goes on increasing until limited by other factors. Increase in carbon dioxide concentration beyond a certain level causes the closure of stomata and it decreases the rate of photosynthesis. Now next topic is respiration. When we burn a fuel, it utilizes oxygen and yields energy in the form of light, heat. In this burning processes, oxygen is used to break the CH bonds present in fuel molecules. In the same way, organisms utilize oxygen for the breakdown of CH bonds present in the food in their cells. This breakdown yields energy, which is transformed into ATP. During this process, the CH bonds are broken by oxidation reduction reaction, and so carbon dioxide and water are also produced. In cellular respiration, food is oxidized to CO2 while O2 is reduced into H2O. The cellular energy yielding process is called cellular respiration. Look at the equation. Here, glucose molecules oxidize in the presence of oxygen and change into carbon dioxide gas and water and releases energy. Now, types of respiration. The most common fuel used by cell to get energy by cellular respiration is glucose. The way glucose is oxidized depends on the availability of oxygen. The cellular respiration occurring in the presence of oxygen is called aerobic respiration, while the one that occurs in the absence of oxygen, it is called anaerobic respiration. Now, first one, aerobic respiration. In the presence of oxygen, complete oxidation of glucose occurs with maximum release of energy. In the first phase of aerobic respiration, a molecule of glucose, 6 carbon, is broken down into 2 molecules of pyruvic acid. In the second phase, molecules of pyruvic acid are completely oxidized. It means all CH bonds are broken down to CO2 and water and all energy is released. Next, anaerobic respiration, which is also called the fermentation. In the absence of oxygen, glucose is incompletely oxidized with less amount of energy released. Incomplete oxidation means not all the CH bonds are oxidized. In anaerobic respiration, the first phase is exactly similar to that of aerobic respiration. A molecule of glucose is broken down into 2 molecules of pyruvic acid, but in the second phase, pyruvic acid is not completely oxidized due to the absence of oxygen. It is transformed into ethyl alcohol or lactic acid. In this way, many of the CH bonds are left unbroken in the products. Anaerobic respiration is further classified as alcoholic fermentation and lactic acid fermentation. Alcoholic fermentation. It occurs in bacteria, yeast. In this type of anaerobic respiration, pyruvic acid is further broken down into alcohol and carbon dioxide gas. Second form, lactic acid fermentation. It occurs in skeletal muscles of humans and other animals. During extreme physical activities, this also happens in the bacteria present in milk. In this type of anaerobic respiration, each pyruvic acid molecule is converted into lactic acid. Even today, when free oxygen is available, some organisms, include some bacteria and some fungi, get energy from anaerobic respiration, so they are called anaerobes. Now, next topic is mechanism of respiration. The process of respiration involves complex series of reactions. For the study of all the reactions of glucose oxidation, we will go into the mechanism of aerobic respiration. Aerobic respiration is a continuous process, but for convenience, we can divide it into 3 main stages. First, glycolysis. Second, Krebs cycle. Third, electron transport chain. Before proceeding to mechanism, you must know about FAD. FAD, it means flavin adenine dinucleotide. It is also a coenzyme that, like NAD, it gets 2 hydrogen and reduces to FADH2. This figure shows the complete process of mechanism of respiration. The first one, glycolysis. Look at the figure, students, 7.12, glycolysis. Glycolysis occurs in cytoplasm and oxygen is not involved in this stage. That is why it occurs in both types of respiration, aerobic and anaerobic. In glycolysis, glucose, which is the 6 carbon compound molecule, is broken into 2 molecules of pyruvic acid. and ATP and NADP is reduced to ATP and NADH. Before entering in Krebs cycle, pyruvic acid is changed into a 2-carbon compound called acetyl coenzyme A. Look at this figure. By entering Krebs cycle, pyruvic acid first of all change into 2-carbon compound which is called acetyl coenzyme A in the presence of coenzyme A. Now next, in Krebs cycle, the pyruvic acid molecules are completely oxidized. It means acetyl coenzyme now completely oxidized with the formation of ATP, NAD, H and FADH2. Now next, with the help of the coenzyme A leave this reaction. Now the next step is electron transport chain. In the electron transfer chain is the first final step of cellular respiration. It is the transfer of electron on an electron transport chain. In this step, NADH and FADH2 release electrons and hydrogen ions. These electrons are taken up by the series of electron carriers. When electrons move through the series of electron carriers, they lose energy, which is used to synthesize ATP. At the end of chain, electrons and hydrogen ions combine with molecular oxygen and form water. Look at the equation. There is oxygen is entered or utilized at that step of the respiration and change into the water molecule. Here ATP, NAD and FAD is now again formed for the next procedure of the respiration. Now next topic is the energy budget of respiration. How many energy molecules are produced during the respiration process? First of all, look at this. Each NADH produces 3 ATP in electron transport chain. Similarly, each FADH2 molecule produces 2 molecules of ATP in ETC. Students, look at this figure number 7.13 carefully. First of all, here the glycolysis process, and then the Krebs cycle, and then electron transport chain. Each NADH produces 3 ATP in electron transport chain. The NADH generated in glycolysis gives 2 ATP because 1 ATP is spent to the transport it occur the mitochondrial membrane. Each FADH2 produces 2 ATP. The total output of ATPs can be calculated from the following data. During anaerobic oxidation of the glucose molecule, only 2 ATP molecules are gained as the net profit because it is produces only from the glycolysis, which is only the 2 ATP molecule. It is because there is no Krebs cycle in Krebs cycle and the electron transport chain in the anaerobic respiration. Again, carefully look on this figure. There is how many 2 NADH molecule produces through the glycolysis, and the 2 ATP molecules are produces during the conversion of the glucose to the pyruvic acid in glycolysis. These 2 ATP are net profit here. Now on the right side, that is 2 NADH, and from the conversion of pyruvic acid into the acetyl coenzyme A, again 2 NADH molecules are produced. Similarly, from the conversion of acetyl coenzyme A to the Krebs cycle, and the conversion is take place to the water molecule, formation of the water molecule through the formation of the carbon dioxide gas molecule. Again here 4 NADH are produced. Similarly, 2 FADH2 are also produced, and 2 ATP molecules are produced. 2 NADH goes to the electron transport chain and produces 4 ATP. 2 NADH produces here 6 ATP. 2 ATPs are utilized during the conversion of the transportation of the across the mitochondrial molecule, and here net is the 4 ATP molecules. Again, from the 2 NADH molecule, the next 2 NADH molecule, the 6 ATP are produced here. 4 NADH from the Krebs cycle produces 18 ATP molecules. 2 FADH2 molecules from the Krebs cycle produces 4 ATP. Now, total number of ATP molecules from the electron transport chain are the 32, and from the Krebs cycle are 22 ATP, and from the glycolysis that are 2 ATP. The total net yield of the ATP during the aerobic respiration are 36 ATP molecules. Now, next topic is table 7.1, which is explained here. Difference between photosynthesis and respiration. Look at this table. There is a main headings are characteristics, photosynthesis and respiration. First point is metabolism. That metabolism in photosynthesis is the anabolism process, and the respiration is the catabolism process. Energy investment, how many production? Investment of light energy to store in the form of bond energy. But in the respiration, bond energy transformed into chemical energy of ATP. Organisms capable of photosynthesis take place in bacteria, all algae, all in all plants. And all organisms performing to get their energy by the process of respiration. Site of occurrence, photosynthesis take place in the chloroplast, and the respiration take place in the cytoplasm as well as inside the mitochondria. Time of occurrence, in daytime only in the presence of light photosynthesis take place, and the respiration take place in all organisms all the time. Now students, table 7.2, which explain difference between aerobic and anaerobic respiration. There is the main heading which are properties, aerobic respiration, anaerobic respiration. The first property, presence of oxygen. Yes, in aerobic respiration, oxygen is necessary, and in anaerobic respiration, there is no need of oxygen. Number of ATP as net profit. Table 7.2 explain difference between aerobic and anaerobic respiration. Here are the main three headings, properties, aerobic respiration, anaerobic respiration. First property, presence of oxygen. Yes, aerobic respiration need oxygen, but in anaerobic respiration there is no need of oxygen. Number of ATPs as net profit. Students, 36 ATP molecules are produced during the aerobic respiration, and only 2 ATP molecules are produced during anaerobic respiration. Final products of the procedure are aerobic respiration CO2 and H2O is produced, and in the anaerobic respiration lactic acid produced, or ethanol and carbon dioxide gas. Site of occurrence, glycolysis in cytoplasm, and Krebs cycle and electron transport chain in mitochondria. But in the aerobic respiration, that is take place only in the cytoplasm. What are the importance of aerobic respiration is that is the major source of energy for most of the organisms. They are called the aerobes. And the importance of anaerobic respiration, it is the source of energy for anaerobic organisms, source of energy for aerobic organisms in short supply of oxygen only in skeletal muscles, source of many products, ethanol, cheese. Now open exercise page number 137. We shall solve the MCQs. The first MCQs, in which of the following steps of respiration carbon dioxide gas is produced? Students, it is in the Krebs cycle. Option B is correct. Oxygen takes part, number 2, oxygen takes part in aerobic respiration in, of course, it is electron transport chain. When a plant was kept in darkness for many days, its leaves turned yellow. Why? The option D, leaves could not get the light, and so there was no photosynthesis. MCQs number 4. From which bonds of ATP molecule energy is taken? Of course, students, this is the point A. From the PP bonds. Number 5. In which component of the leaf cells chlorophyll is present? Of course, it is thylakoids. 6. Which of these can enter into Krebs cycle? Of course, it is acetyl coenzyme A. When we work hard, we suffer from muscle fatigue because muscle cells. Option C. Carry out anaerobic respiration and so accumulate lactic acid. Number 8. How many molecules of carbon dioxide gas are produced when Krebs cycle operates once? Student, note this. Krebs cycle operates once. The correct option is 2. Because of that, when the Krebs cycle operates one, there is the product entrance of the acetyl coenzyme A, which is the conversion from the 2-pyruvic acid molecule of the 3 carbon compounds into the 2 carbon compounds. When the one acetyl molecule, which is the 2 carbon compound, goes through the Krebs cycle, it produces 2 molecules of carbon dioxide gas. Number 9. In which of the following metabolic processes, oxidation as well as reduction of molecules occur? Students, look at this. Option number C, both. Because of that, photosynthesis and the respiration both are that processes in which the oxidation and the reduction reaction occur. The 10th, chlorophyll pigment absorb maximum light in wavelength of course, you know, red and blue. This chapter is very important. Do practice of all the diagrams at least 2 times on your notebook. As I have explained you all the topics, try solving the exercise short questions on your notebooks. That are only 4 short questions given at the end of your exercise. And the long questions, which is under heading understanding the concept, these all the questions, which are total 8 questions, they are explained in your text. So thank you, students.